If you have an underfloor that's constructed out of web trusses like these, then perhaps you're wondering how you can insulate it. Hi, I'm Maurice Beinat. I'm Technical Director at ecoMaster, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can easily insulate a subfloor made out of web trusses such as these. So in order to insulate an underfloor made out of web trusses, there's really just two parts to it. You can certainly use our regular underfloor material, and if you measure the spacing, the centers, so leading edge to leading edge, it's probably going to be about 450, the same as our material. But of course you can't just lay it straight across, because as you can see, the web trusses have a 90 mil timber laid on the flat. So that causes us a little bit of an issue. So the simple thing to do here is actually cut the material lengthways into two, so that the big piece fits between the trusses and the little offcut gets pushed up between the webs. Okay, so the part in the middle gets stapled to the floor, so pull aside a little bit and staple through about 20 or 30 millimeters of the material into the floor. And the part that gets threaded through the web truss, well, mostly it gets held up by the material either side, but you may need the odd staple just here and there just to secure it, and of course where parts join together. So let's have a look now at that actually being done. The first part is to measure the space between the web trusses and add 10 millimeters and cut a length along the material to that width. And the offcut we're going to put in the web truss. So step one, measure and cut. Step two, fit to the floor. The first step is to measure the space between the trusses. So in this case we've got 365, and so we're going to cut the material at 375, and the offcut is going to go in there. Before cutting the material, it's important to set up a nice work surface. So a good idea is a couple of the underfloor rolls on the flat like this together, and something on the top that you can cut into, so that we're going to put the material over the top and we're going to cut along this way and pull the material along and cut, so that that way we can cut any length up to the full roll at the same width. Once we've got our work surface ready, then we can unroll some of the underfloor material on top of our cutting surface, and then we're ready to go. Now, it's really good to have a piece of straight timber so that you can just lay it on the surface of the material that you're going to cut. It's going to make it very easy to run the angle grinder along the edge of the timber. So we need 375, so we can just put the use a measuring tape to line up the edge of the timber at the appropriate place. Like that. And then the next thing is to run the angle grinder along the timber just to mark the cut, then move the timber off and complete the cut with one or two further passes with the angle grinder. Make sure you got your ear defenders on. 9-inch grinder, straight edge ready to go. Take the straight edge off. We've got our cut there. Okay, so we just need one more cut in order to finish this off. So there's the cut. This part is going to go between the web trusses and we're going to staple through just 20 or 30 millimeters of this each side into the floor. It's good to use the slightly tougher edge rather than the fluffier edge. Use a slightly tougher edge against the floor in this case and staple along like that, and the offcut gets slipped into the web trussing and then turned sideways. It's going to end up about the same level as the bottom of the insulation, and you might need one or two staples just where the web trussing is less frequent, just to hold it together, and also if you need to join pieces, then staple where there are joins. But basically, using this method, you can cut any length up to the full 11.6 meters of the roll and go all the way across. So we've cut the material and we're ready now to fit. So we start with the slightly heavier side towards the floor, and we're just going to feed it in like this and push it up like so, and then we're going to pull the material aside a little bit and staple into the floor. Once the centerpiece is fitted firmly, then it's time to fit the offcut into the web trussing. So the way we do that is we're going to thread it this way, and then we're going to turn it 90 degrees like that and push it up hard. That's it. And make sure you turn it 90 degrees. You'll need a staple in the end, and you might need a staple here where there's not much web trussing. Otherwise, when the material goes in the other side, it's going to press into that and it's going to hold it pretty firmly up against the floor. And so you can see we're going to have quite a nice finish. So there you have it. You can see above me the finished result. So simple to do. First up, measure the width between the trusses. Remember that it may be different from time to time, that not necessarily all uniform. Cut the material along the length. A piece of timber is a great tool to facilitate that. Use a 9-inch grinder. Be careful, of course, rotating machinery, so you wear ear protection. And then staple up in place and thread the offcut through the webbing and turn 90 degrees. You're going to get a great result like this. Everything's going to be perfectly insulated. So there you have it, how to insulate an underfloor that's made out of web trusses. Thanks for watching. I hope that's been helpful.